Hello all, welcome back. The next example on Gauss divergence theorem. Evaluate double integration over S x cube I bar plus y cube j bar plus z cube k bar dot ds bar, where S is the surface of sphere x square plus y square plus z square equals to 16. So see, here we have to evaluate double integration over the surface S. This vector quantity called as the f bar dot ds bar, that is similar to the LHS of Gauss divergence theorem. So to solve this, we are going to use the Gauss divergence theorem. So what is Gauss divergence theorem? Double integration over S, f bar dot n cap ds is equals to triple integration over volume V, del dot f bar dv. Now, compare the LHS of the statement and the LHS of the Gauss divergence theorem. So here, we have to put the value of f bar is x cube I bar plus y cube j bar plus z cube k bar. So let f bar is equals to x cube I bar plus y cube j bar plus z cube k bar. So put value of f bar on the both sides of this statement of Gauss divergence theorem. We will get double integration over S x cube I bar plus y cube j bar plus z cube k bar dot n cap ds is similar to ds bar is equals to triple integration over volume V del dot f bar. Del is I bar into dab by dab x plus j bar into dab by dab y plus k bar into dab by dab z dot product with f bar. F bar is x cube I bar plus y cube j bar plus z cube k bar into dv. This is equals to triple integration over V. Now we have to take a dot product of these two vector quantities. So you know that the dot product is given by the component wise multiplication and addition. That means the coefficient of I bar is dab by dab x here and coefficient of I bar is x cube. So we have to take derivative of x cube with respect to x. So derivative of x cube with respect to x, it is 3x square plus sign. Now coefficient of j bar is here dab by dab y. Here coefficient of j bar is y cube. That means take a derivative of y cube with respect to y. So it is 3y square. Similarly, derivative of z cube with respect to z, it is 3z square into this dv. Now, simplifying that 3 taking outside common term. So 3 times triple integration over v x square plus y square plus z square into dv. We will get this. Now that dv can be written as, this is volume integral, so dv can be written as dx into dy into dz. Dv is same as dx into dy into dz. Now we have to evaluate this triple integration over the volume v x square plus y square plus z square dx dy dz. So to evaluate this triple integration, we have to find the limits. So as we learn in the last year, the concept of multiple integral. So you have to evaluate this triple integral over which surface? We have given the surface of sphere x square plus y square plus z square equals to 16. So we have given the surface is a sphere, so we can use the spherical polar coordinates. So using spherical polar coordinates or transformation. So what is the spherical polar transformation? X is equals to r sin theta cos phi, y is equals to r sin theta sin phi, and z is equals to r cos theta. Then we will get the value of dx into dy into dz is equals to r square sin theta r square sin theta into dr d theta d phi. Also we will get the value of x square plus y square plus z square is equals to r square. And for the whole sphere, we are going to evaluate this triple integral over the whole surface of the sphere. So we know that for whole sphere, r varies from 0 to radius of the sphere. We have given the radius of sphere is 4, because the equation of sphere is x square plus y square plus z square equals to 16. So that is the surface of the sphere is 4. Then theta varies from 0 to, for the whole sphere, theta varies from 0 to pi, and phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. These are the limits for whole sphere, complete sphere. Now putting all these values in this equation, in equation number 1. So we will get double integration over s, x cube I bar plus y cube j bar plus z cube k bar dot ds bar is equals to 3 times triple integration, out of that r varies from 0 to 4, second integration theta varies from 0 to pi, and third phi varies from 0 to 2 pi into x square, y square, z square. Value of x square, y square, z square is r square. Into dx dy dz, value of dx dy dz is r square sin theta dr d theta d phi. Now simplifying this, now all limits are constant, so we can separate the integral. 3 into r varies from 0 to 4, terms of r are r square into r square, that is r raised to 4 dr, multiply by theta varies from 0 to pi, terms of theta is sin theta d theta, multiply by phi varies from 0 to 2 pi, the term of phi is d phi. This is equals to 3 into integration of r raised to 4 is r raised to 5 upon 5, having limits 0 to 4. Multiply by integration of sin theta is minus of cos theta, having limit 0 to pi. Multiply by integration of d phi is phi 0 to 2 pi. This is equals to 3 into, when you put value of r is 4 here, so you will get here 4 raised to 5 upon 5. And when you put lower limit 0, so you will get this term as a 0. Multiply by minus of cos pi, minus minus plus cos of 0. Multiply by, when you put upper limit, so you will get 2 pi. And when you put lower limit, pi equals to 0, you will get 0. So this is 3 into 4 raised to 5 upon 5. Multiply by cos pi is minus 1, and this minus 1, that is minus minus plus 1. Cos 0 is again plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 2 into 2 pi. After simplifying this, we will get this answer. That is our final answer.